What I do usually, I simply say, when people say there is no right, simply say that there is a right. You cannot deny this right. And I try to explain, first of all, what the right mean. The right, as I said, for Israelis, usually they think that if there is a right, there is no right for Israelis here, which of course is not true, and it's not the case, and it's not also the demand by the Palestinians who are working or demanding the right to return. They don't say, okay, Israelis go from here, we are coming back. There is no such a demand. But people should first of all understand the right itself. For example, it's good to remember that the 194 resolution was accepted in the UN on December 11, 1948, calling to, for the return of the refugees in sooner as possible, or something like that. But it was, this resolution was taken one day after the 10th of December, which is the Declaration of Human Rights, you know, by the UN. So it was in the context of the human rights. There is one of these human rights is the right of return, and it's written also in the December 10, you know, Declaration for Human Rights. Article 13 says that any person can leave his country or his home and return safely to his place. So it's the right is there. There's no such question. Now I think what usually I say to Israelis, that the right of return and the acceptance and the materializing of the right of return, or the materializing of the return itself, is the chance for us to live in peace here. For me, if I talk to Jews in the US, I would say that if you want to help us, if you care about us, Israeli Jews living there in this country, you know, in the Middle East, and you want us to live in peace, to support us, I think what you should do is to support the right of return. Because without this, what you support is the continuous war forever. I mean, we don't have security here. There's, no, I think, no doubt about it. And if you really care for our security and somehow some possibility to live in peace here, it's only by accepting this right. Now, it doesn't mean that this is the only, I mean, it's not the only thing we need here is to accept the right of return. There are some more, few more things we should do. But this is necessary, this is essential. For sure there will be no peace without accepting this right. So I try to convince, you know, my fellow Israelis as in what I would say more pragmatic ways, not so much abstract or legal discussion, because this is usually not very much fruitful, not very fruitful usually. But I think really, when we show this, for example, these projects that we do, those practicalities of return that we began with it, and you can see it on our website, I think it raised many ideas on how this really could work. And it shows that we talk about return, but not about expulsion of any others. So I think it's yeah.